So here we are standing in front of a 7-year-old Italian stone pine. Italian stone pines are very common around Las Cruces. And there's about, I'd say about 5 different pines in this area. You have a Japanese black, you have Italian stone pine, you have the Aleppo pine, you have the Afghan pine, and now and then you'll find a chur pine. Afghan pines are one of the most popular pine trees in this area. They're often used for Christmas trees, and they work the best for this area. They are a natural desert pine. But we're looking right now at an Italian stone pine. And what I want to show you, there were, from the freeze damage that we had, the Afghan pines were not damaged. So you'll look around town, you'll see them very deep green throughout the whole city. Some people confuse the Aleppo pine with the Afghan pine. And I know in the 80s, the two species actually were mixed together. However, with this really deep freeze, now we're seeing the differences. So if you have an Aleppo pine and it's turned totally brown, that's what it is. It's not an Afghan pine. So let's look what the damage is on these pines. We have needle burning. Even on the Italian stone pine, which is a little bit more cold hardy than the Aleppo, they both come from the Mediterranean region. So the Italian stone pine got light damage, what we call light to moderate. And it's already growing back. If you have the Aleppo pine, it's probably all brown. And what you want to do before you go out and cut it down is look and make sure that it is alive or it is dead. And you'll see the really brown needles on it. But what you want to look for are little green buds. There could be life in your Aleppo pine. So look really close. You're going to look at the stems really close here. And we can see it's been 2 months and we can see new growth coming on this Italian stone pine. And you should see the same thing happening on your Aleppo pine. Like I said, the Afghan pine should be fine. And what you want to do is just keep your pines watered and wait. If you have a pine that's in a precarious situation, like between a house and it's a really large pine, what you want to do is have a professional arborist, and I say professional arborist, come and look at your tree and make sure whether it is alive or it is dead, because you may have to remove it. And that's a big expense. But you don't want a pine tree of that size, up to 60, 70 feet, coming down on your property or your neighbor's property and hurting anybody. But make sure that it is alive or it is dead before you spend up to $1,000 to have your tree removed. Here we have another popular Southwest plant, and that's the pomegranate. Some of you know it as Granada. And here's some old mummified pomegranates from last year. Now, pomegranates normally can take about 10 degrees. And they'll grow back and be just fine. However, again, with the 5 below 0 temperatures, most of the pomegranates around here froze to the ground. I want you to look right here, though, however, the roots are hardy and they're coming back. So from the crown and the bud sprouts down low, we have a pomegranate starting to come back. Now, you're not going to have pomegranates this year. It may take up to 2 years before they'll start flowering again, but you didn't lose the plant. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut off these old dead stems and allow room for the new ones to grow back into your new plant, and so you'll have pomegranates again. So let's take the lopping shears again. And what we're going to do is cut down low. Perhaps you can see the bud right here, just below the stem. So we're going to cut just above that. Now this is a smaller pomegranate. Some of you have really large pomegranate. So there's one stem off. And this is pretty big, so I may need to use the saw, which I put over there. Put those aside, and we're gonna use the hand saw here, and we're gonna get down in here. Let me move this rock, and we can start cutting. Okay, so now we got that off. We remove this. That'll grow up into your next new beautiful pomegranate. And there you go. This is a tapozon or butterfly tree. Buddleia cordata is its Latin name. It is frozen to the ground. It's native to Chihuahua, Mexico, but it makes a beautiful tree here in Las Cruces. What I want you to look at, you see the size of it? Any of my previous hand cutting tools, the pruners, the lopping shears and that, they're not gonna be effective on this tree. The trunk on it is about 5 inches in diameter. It's way too big to cut through without a chainsaw. So let's step in here and let me show you. Here you can see we have the tapozon coming back from the roots. And this is what I've been telling people, is that you need to cut this tree down, check to make sure it's dead, cut it back to the base before you have all this new growth coming up. Because now if you're going to cut it back to the base, virtually all this is dead above it. And to get close enough to the ground to remove this means you're going to have to probably cut these new stems coming out from the trunk here. And that'll set the tree back again. Because right now, the tree is putting all of its energy from the roots into putting out all this new growth. And the importance for having these leaves is to make energy for the root system so that it can keep growing. Without the energy from the sun made in the leaves and the carbohydrates here, the roots would cease and the whole tree would die. So we'll have to get a chainsaw on this tree here to take that out. And here we have a Mediterranean olive tree. Again, the tree just looks pretty dead. We'll take this scratch here. You can see that? All brown. So that's all dead. We scratched down lower. Get some green in here. So this tree is probably alive right in this area. So then we'd have to make the decision whether we want to remove it right about in here or we want to cut it to the ground and let all this new growth regenerate. Sometimes if you cut them, you get the stub and they don't heal very well. This actually, as an olive tree, will heal. It'll make it more gnarly. I would consider cutting it up higher since it's got this nice big trunk already. The thing is, if you cut it here, you get more suckers at the bottom. So you can see the proliferation of growth here. You're going to have to select in here one or two stems or whatever you'd like to have, however many trunks you'd like to have, and weed out the rest, put the energy into those. But it'll be a beautiful tree in short order. I've seen them frozen before. The bigger they get, the bigger the trunk is, the more green wood you'll have up higher on the stem. And if that were to happen again, you can always cut it back higher up on the stem and you'll have a tree much faster. So I would cut it right about here. I think that would work really well.